We're gonna talk about what's going on. This is Glendon Cameron, your hustling godfather. Back at you again with another video. What we're gonna talk about in the realm of what we talk about all the time on this channel is how to start businesses. We're gonna talk about the absolute worst business that you can start. The absolute worst business. And I'm gonna give you a few tips on things not to do. Tip number one, don't start a business on hearsay. What is that? Well, I heard that those Amazon FBA people make a lot of money. Well, I heard those Shopify store owners make a lot of money. You're operating on hearsay. You're not operating on practical knowledge. And typically when you start a business on hearsay versus true earned knowledge, it's gonna fail. It's just gonna fail. Another tip here, never start a business based upon what you feel will be. Well, don't start a business that goes against your strengths. Never start a business. Let's say you're good in math and you want to get into raising chickens or something. More likely it ain't gonna work out because your strong suit's math. You would probably be better doing software coding or something like that. So you never want to start a business that operates against your strengths. This is one of the reasons that so many people start businesses and fails. Like operating the business out of your strength. You let's say it's a hearsay business. You don't know anything about the business. You have no connections. You have nothing. You've got to learn that business, operate that business, learn how to sell that business, learn how to market that business, do all of that stuff because you don't know and you're operating from a position of weakness. More than likely that's going to fail because you have such an uphill battle. So, you know, many of the worst businesses to start are businesses that are out of alignment with who you are as a person. Let's say you're a vegan and you're going to start a fur business that because it makes money. If you haven't noticed, people wearing furs, real furs, has fallen out of favor. I haven't checked, but I guarantee if I check, the decline of real mink fur sales has probably declined drastically because a lot of people are vegans and they don't believe in wearing animals and they don't believe in harming animals. So that could be a losing business right out the get-go. And one of the worst things that you can do is start a business on the ego. Well, I can do it. Like, I will give you a good example of this. Like the YouTube. YouTube is a business, and they get many people like that will disagree with what I'll say, and they'll say something like, well, I should start a YouTube channel. And I go ahead and say, do it! Please do! And send me the link so I can talk trash on your channel. And they never start the channel because it's their ego. I said something that pissed them off or made them feel some kind of way. And they're like, well, I'm going to start YouTube. I'm gonna start. You know, this looks easy, but it ain't easy. I've been doing this 10 plus years. 10 plus years, player. 10 plus. And you want to come up here and do it like one of the things that's happening, like starting a YouTube channel and talking about Red Pill and MGTO. It's in the toilet because YouTube is taking away the monetization of most of these channels and there just isn't as much Red Pill and MGTO content as it used to be. So that's another bad reason to start a business or to get into something, because it's popular. Don't do that. Don't do that because, you know, if it's popular and it's trendy, it's up today, and there's going to be a day in the future where it's going to be down. And you started your business based on a trend or popularity, and you've invested all this time. Like, there are so many people who've started MGTO channels, Red Pill channels. They invested all this time. They bought equipment. And when they had the monetization, it was well worth it. Now YouTube said, no, 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 we're not going to monetize those type of videos. You can make them, but you ain't going to get paid. And all of a sudden, you've seen that a lot of people have reduced their output of the MGTOW and Red Pill content because they can't get paid because they, you know, honestly, a lot of those dudes were married. A lot of those dudes were dealing with fat chicks. A lot of those dudes, that's why they hid their faces. You didn't know who they was. So if you you couldn't run into your favorite MGTOW content creator into town because you didn't know what they looked like. You had no clue. There's a reason that they hid. So, you know, just never start a business because it's popular. Remember those Hoover boards? And they were like the craze and everybody was ordering them and selling them. I saw those boards for like $99 in Best Buy recently. They were selling these boards for $300. Don't start a business. Don't, you know, buy products just because they're popular. That's just not the way to go. Another reason you should, and this is more things, you shouldn't start a business with people who are not as hardworking as you are. If you start a business with people who are not as industrious as you are, you're going to have conflicts, you're going to have problems. Because here's the thing, in the early days, everybody's agreed we're gonna split this 50-50, you know, there's four partners, 25%. And when it's time to get paid, everybody wants their percentage, whether they work for it or not, because that was the promise. The promise was, you know, you're part of this organization, you're gonna get 25%. And when it comes time for that money to be put out, they want their 25%, whether they work for it or not. And humans are really funny about pay. Like, if someone doesn't do their job, they just show up every day, they want to be paid for their time. And they will fight you. They will file complaints if you check them. And they're like, well, Ed, you weren't really working on this day, so we ain't going to pay you. It will tear that place up. It will have the police up in there because they're like, I was here and you need to pay me. And this is one of the things that humans do. Another thing, one of the worst things you could do is start a business and expect to be paid immediately. This YouTube channel, I started it August 6, 2009. I did not make a dime for 6 months of full-time work. Now there's a reason I was able to invest this time into creating and building this channel, because I had exited a very profitable business. I had money in the bank. I had no bills. So I was in a position to devote 6 months of hard full-time work on this business and make it successful. So do not, one of the worst things you do is start a business and think you're going to be paid immediately. You're going to be paid in year 3 or year 2 or year 4. And this is one of the things that trips up so many people, because they're like, I'm J.G. Wentworth. I need my money now. And one of the things that's going to mess you up is whether you're working actively towards your business. You know, it's January 2020. And you start now in January 2023, that's when the cake starts coming. But you like, I want to eat cake now. I want to have my cake and ice cream now. And you don't get it and you just stopped. And here it is, 2023, and you've done nothing. And the time has passed. Whether you're actively working on your business model or not, if you live long enough, the time's going to pass. 2023 is going to get here and you ain't going to have no business. You ain't going to have no cake. You ain't going to have nothing. You ain't going to have nothing. So one of the things I want you guys to understand is you should start businesses that are in alignment with your strengths, in alignment with your talents. So I know someone's going to put this question in the comments. Someone answer. What if I don't have no strengths? What if I don't have no talents? Start a service business. You don't know what to do. You don't know what you're strong in. You have no talents. You have no hobbies. Start a service business. That's the quickest way for you to get money with limited to no experience. So be sure to go to the front of the channel and toggle through the playlist and start watching all these business videos. Give you the game so you can be successful. There's a lot of content here. So with that, I'll see you guys later.